Hey everyone, so we're here at Visible Changes Salon to finally get my hair shaved. It's been falling out all day. My scalp feels strange. It feels like stinging and hot in some places, and it's just uncomfortable. And my hair is just, it comes out just in strands. Not full on clumps yet, but it's gonna get there. So, yeah, we're here to do that. So we'll be back once it's actually time to shave, and then they're gonna bring some wigs for me to try on. So see you guys then. What do you think?
It's cute, yeah? Looks natural.
It does.
Yeah.
Yeah. It feels weird. Doesn't feel like me. It's gonna be starting soon. It'll grow back. Eventually. Strawberry, or watermelon.
Watermelon, strawberry, yeah.
It's good, watermelon is good.
Yeah. With sugar rim.
Yeah, sugar.
daddy at Willie's.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
How many do you want?
Five.
Five?
I don't know if I can go to work tomorrow. Oh, it feels so weird having air in my head.
Because she just spent a bunch of money coloring it too.
And I hate it. I hate the color. So. Let me see your scarf, Kai. Oh, that's cute. That's really cute. No, I like that. I have that other scarf, the other one that was on back order, it's in my car. How am I looking?
You look like a punk rocker right now.
What are grandmothers for? What are teaching? I'm cutting my hair because I didn't get it shaved last night. I had one more day of training I had to do, and I'm newly single. And I was a little scared of being single and bald, but whatever. I'll try to grow a beard instead. Be the bearded bald lady. Ooh, that would look good.
Oh, look in the camera.
Oh my god. You're making hair go down my boobs. Okay. All right, here we go. I have no idea what I'm doing back here.
I've always wanted to cut my hair like this, though.
Well, now you do. Now you're doing it.
I'm doing it.
So we're going to need a sweep.
We're just going to be the bald family.
We are. Whenever three of us go out to eat, we'll just all be bald.
Yeah. I'm going to rock it. Rock it like a rock star.
This is one of my hats that I bought, or that Papa bought for me, my grandpa. So it's got mushrooms all over it. That's what my head looks like.
What do you think?
Actually, it looks cute. You could just leave it like that. Maybe just like go to a salon and then have them like fix it up.
I've missed some spots.
You look cute.
I miss spots. Oh, I'm making a mess.
It's okay. We got rooms.
Oh, I think it's going in my pants. But I didn't take those off.
Yeah, she didn't take her pants off. So don't worry, you too.
It's family safe. All right, how do I look?
You actually legitimately look cute.
How do I look? Do I just look fantastic? Told my coworkers they have to tell me I'm beautiful.
That's what I told Marcus.
You have to tell me I'm beautiful when I come back bald. And then I told him, don't tell HR I said that. And I work for HR.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Head down.
How do I look?
How does it feel?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, right?
That's all you can really say.
It feels soft.
Do I feel soft?
There's a... Oh, no, that's our mole.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. She's like, I will add your hair to mine and we will become
you
one.
Just had a bath, you bitch.
Hello everyone. So it's the day after the shave and all three of us have gotten our heads shaved, and so I'm gonna let Gigi talk about why she did hers.
Well, Kylie invited me to come along when she was getting her hair done and getting it shaved. And I sat there watching and I saw the emotion that she was going through. And I guess it really hit my heart. I honestly had the tears in my eyes and thought, you know, I want to support her. I don't know how to do this, but I just want to be there for her. And the more I watched, the more I thought, I'm going to have my head shaved. So when she was finishing up with Kylie, I said, can you do mine? And she said, sure. So I sat in the chair and I was next and told Kylie I would be her twin. And Marcus was behind us saying, no, I think we're triplets. So that's kind of how it happened. How it happened for me.
All right, well, for me, I wanted to go ahead and say, do me next. But to be honest, I was also very scared. I had training that I had to finish up today, you know, so I'm standing up in front of a room full of people. I'm newly single, and I was like, oh my God, new hair, single.
And I was telling her, you don't need to do it since you're newly single.
And she was saying, you don't have to do it. And I was like, I will. And And I went home last night and I regretted not doing it. I woke up this morning and while I was drying my hair, I was regretting not doing it. And so I called her and she said she was still sad and still kind of depressed about it. And I asked, would it help if I do it? And she said, I think it would. So I said, well, will Marcus shave my head for me when I'm done with work today? So as soon as I was done with work, I came over and we shaved my head as well.
Yep. So for me, when she first started chopping my hair, because my hair was long, so she had to chop off bits and pieces of it before she could start shaving. When she started just chopping away at it, that's when I really was like, okay, this is actually happening. And that's when it actually fully hit me. And that's why my emotions were just so strong. And to me, it almost felt like a part of myself was being cut off. Like, it's different than just a normal haircut to me. Like, I've gone short before. I've never gone full on pixie cut, but I've had short hair like down to like here, down to like here, and I've had like asymmetrical cuts. But I've never had anything like this, and it was kind of traumatic actually. And she was asking me, do you want me to stop? And I was like, no, just rip it off like a band-aid, you know, just keep going. Just keep going. I don't want you to stop because then I might say, don't keep going, you know. But today I woke up feeling kind of depressed. But as the day kind of went on, I started feeling better. And I'm getting more used to seeing myself this way. And Marcus, my boyfriend, has been very supportive today. He was working from home today, so he was with me all day. He was very supportive, and last night he was also really supportive. And so that meant a lot to me, but it was, like I said, it was really traumatic, I think, to just have it. Like, for them, it's different. Because they chose to do it. I don't have a choice to look like this. And theirs will grow back if they choose not to shave it again. Mine won't.
Well, for a while.
For a while, yeah. But what I'm trying to come to terms with is that my hair is not me. I am not my hair. But it's still hard, but you are not your hair. So if you do have to shave it off for whatever reason, most of the time it should grow back unless you have some other kind of condition. But for chemotherapy patients, it will grow back when chemotherapy is done. And that's what I'm trying to tell myself, like, I'll get it back. I'll get it back. And I look pretty cute in my scarves and my hats. So that's better.
But we're rocking the bald heads right now.
I'm not. I don't like, my face is so puffy because of the steroid that they gave me during chemotherapy, so I just don't feel like I look good at all.
You're a cutie.
No. But yeah, so that was a lot. So we had to wait until the next day to film this outro, but I'm glad we did because she decided to shave her head, so we were just able to do all this in one video. But I was just so emotionally exhausted last night. She wanted to film an outro when we were out to eat, and I was like, no, I just can't do that right now. I don't have the energy to do an outro.
But she had the energy for two drinks.
I had the energy for two drinks. And I have the energy tonight for how many drinks? Three drinks? Three drinks.
Don't tell the doctor.
Well, doctor doesn't need to know. She's not watching this.
Okay. All right, so we got three generations of bald heads.
Bald heads.
Yep. So I want to thank you for joining me on my journey. And I hope you guys continue to watch my channel. So please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time.